vision, it will impact towards health as we age also, and so your results will be off. Especially higher than 56. With armor oxygen, for sure you have some oxygen in your armor, so yes, it's a problem. How are you going to overcome this? And the resolution requires you to have a goal. So maybe the power goal is not enough, but it's beyond the scope of this class that you can, you know, how are you going to do it if you want to resolve this iron and this thing? Condition means that you run it at lower power, which means that there's less power in the plasma. Hopefully this ERO will be less than 54. Okay. And who is doing the dynamic collision cell? Yes, they will explain. We don't have that downstairs. I simply mass spec with the collision cell or the dynamic reaction cell, which is much more expensive and can overcome these problems as well. Of course, C3 with argon and sodium. If you have sodium in your sample, the likelihood that this will have this will form and be interfering ion of same as chloride with arsenic. So, because of these possibilities, the acid used in your sample preparation, even to my skin, I expect you to try not to use PCL, use nitrates on your skin. So this is a common problem in ICP aspect. So the spectroscopic interference is because you have other species of same mass. Okay. Well, this is the detector. And one other thing that I want to for you to read up, I think we need that day on low discharge electron emission, where how the ions are formed, the sample is going to be introduced into a low discharge and undergo desolvation, vaporization, atomization in the flow discharge, and then you put it into your blood aspect. So some of the one, and there is a small part in the test to read about. There's a part in the under atomization. There's another part under mass spec, so please can you read that. What would be the disadvantage of having a low discharge source of ions, so that the ions can then be detected and by the mass spec, okay? Because with this low discharge, one advantage is you can do solid samples. Remember, we were discussing about ARC-SPARC emission, which is used in the metal industry, where they can put in their metal and do the analysis directly in the metal without having to digest the metal in acid. Dissolve the metal first, then put it into the nebulizer, then do the emission spectroscopy. So ARC-SPARC, ARC is one kind of emission spectroscopy. SPARC emission is another kind. Okay, so with spark emission, spectroscopy, we can do solid samples. Similarly, with low discharge, it also works out to be an advantage there too. So we can do direct analysis. So this is another word that you must understand. When we say direct analysis, you can put the sample into the instrument as it is. Who is doing slurry, introduction slurries? Has everybody seen the article? Introduction of slurries in a heat that big one? Yes. Okay. Plant samples, is it? Plant samples, they homogenize the plant samples and form into like a slurry class. Do you say slurry? Have you taken slurry before? Slurry level slurry? Yes, that's right. But now it's your plant, which is homogenized to very small particles, and then you can introduce it directly into the still reaching completion, you know, has a high frequency of blending, which will get these samples, food samples, into smaller particles. Why won't it be small? Why won't the particles be small? If they are big, free, then they are going to get stuck. So we want the very fine particles, but in the form of slurry. Compared to if you digest your food, your plant samples, it will become clear, which is nothing clear. Okay, so you have those slurry atomization, production of slurry versus the production of your digested samples. So here is another example of diathermansis. So that's what we need. So diathermansis of blood means you can put the blood into your breath apparatus and analyze it. You will have to do some sample treatment to the blood so that it becomes a clear solution and be diabetic. Of course, there are problems with diabetes, which you should know in the questions that are asked. What are the problems of involved with diabetes of samples? For example, compared to even digesting the sample and introducing it as a clear solution. What else are things going to be? It's not yet. Since I've kind of wrapped up my part of it. Any questions? I haven't dated your last one this Friday, but your assignment on emissions spectroscopy the problem given the last problems given, where you have a blank. You got a blank? Then you have your standard and your sample. And then when you run a blank, you get some money. Or your solvent, whatever. So if the blend, usually ideally you don't want the blend should be blend. If the blend should not be ready. But that's the ideal situation. Sometimes in your solvent or in your acid, in your marker, there's something that is ready. So your blend is ready. So this reading is not due to your analyte acid. So when you do your standard, you get a certain reading. Your sample gets the reading. So what you should do is correct these readings for your plan. It means to subtract. Because when you are doing your standard, this emission intensity reading that you get this to the standard to be analyzed in the standard plus a plan. So you should subtract that out. Similarly in the sample, the reading is due to the analyze the sample plus something in the plan. The blend is in here. Okay, the solvent, the acid, the buffer that you're using, all is in this solution to learn to subtract the value from those things. Before you do your integration, subtract whatever blend it is. Okay? So when you do your mini regression, you just use the corrected readings. And it has some with regards to statistics, I think in chapter 1, whatever standardization that you have to do with regards to slow, yeah, it's not counted. You need to know just to calculate standardization with regards to precision. That means you do the standard 10 times, and you get the standardization for that 10 times. That's all that is required. For example, you're not responsible for the chapter 1 goes into that, right? Sanitation of the final result, that's the physical part.